I'm throwing all these matchsticks in the air right now as part of an experiment to calculate something, and the result is just delightfully surprising. You see, the cardboard on the ground has a bunch of parallel lines, each spaced apart equal to one length of a matchstick. When a matchstick lands, it'll fall into one of two categories. Sometimes it will cross over one of the lines. Other times it'll land completely between a pair of lines. But what is the probability of each outcome? Well, let's make a bucket for the matches that intersect and the matches that don't intersect. As I'm counting them all up, I'd encourage you to pause the video here and make a guess as to how the final counts will compare to each other. It feels to me, at least, more likely that a match would end up intersecting one of the lines, and indeed that is the case. I ended up with 202 that intersect and 115 that don't. So maybe at this point you're thinking it might be twice as likely that a match intersects a line than not. But now let's do a trick. Take the total number of matches, so that's 115 plus 202, or 317, and multiply it by 2, so 634. Now divide by the number of intersections, 202. We get roughly 3.1386. Now, you've seen the title of the video, so you might know where this is going, but just for fun, let's do a computer simulation of the experiment, where instead of just a few hundred matches, we'll do 100,000. So let's toss the matches randomly somewhere on the screen, and now we'll see which ones intersect one of the lines. I'll color those in yellow, and the ones that don't intersect in green. This time, there are 36,332 that don't intersect, and 63,668 that do. So let's plug these numbers into the same formula as before. 2 times the total number of matches divided by the number of intersections. And this time, we get roughly 3.141295. For reference, here's the value of pi, the most famous number in math, normally defined as the ratio of a circle's circumference to its diameter. It's not a coincidence that these two numbers are so similar. If you're still not convinced, let's run the experiment again, but now with 10 billion matches. This is far too many for me to make an animation of due to computational restrictions, so instead I wrote this Python program that just calculates everything without rendering any visuals. It took over an hour to run this on my computer, but lo and behold, the result now looks even more like pi. So yes, the theoretical result of this experiment, as you throw more and more matches, approaches exactly pi. Now, to be clear, this is not by any means meant to be an efficient way of calculating pi. It's far from efficient. As you just saw, we needed 10 billion matches just to get a few correct digits of pi. Not to mention that for each one of those matches, you have to calculate whether it intersects one of the lines or not. And once you've done all that, the final result is only a randomized approximation with an expected value equal to pi, not an exact answer. But efficiency, and really practicality in general, isn't the point here. The interest in this demonstration comes from the question of, why on earth is pi even relevant here? We're just dropping some matches on a bunch of parallel lines. How is that at all related to the ratio of a circle's circumference to its diameter? I remember being just absolutely fascinated when I first learned about this. It was actually a homework problem for my probability class in college to prove the answer. And of course, this was on a problem set with a bunch of other questions as well, so there was definitely no supposition that pi would show up. And when it did, it just felt almost magical. I will explain why the math works out to be exactly pi. It comes from a special case of a well-known problem. But to build the suspense a little bit, that's going to be delayed until a future video, because my goal is for that future video to include a lot more as well, and that extra content will come directly from you. This is the fourth instance of a series on this channel called Brainstorm, which features viewer submissions to community math challenges that I put out. For those of you new to this series, the previous three episodes have been really awesome, with tons of great viewer submissions. Check them out in the description below. Firstly, I want to challenge you all watching to prove, on your own, why the result of the experiment I showed with the matches is exactly pi. and I'm quite aware that this experiment has a name and is Googleable, but I'm purposefully leaving that out here to give you the opportunity to discover the answer yourself. And in addition, it'd be nice to see if anyone can come up with novel and/or interesting insights about the problem that you may not find from a quick internet search. But that's actually not the main challenge I have for you. You see, when I came across this problem again recently, it just got me thinking. There are so many similarly ridiculous ways that pi shows up in math where you really might not expect it at first. And wondering what else might be out there, I wanted to challenge you to find or invent your favorite or strangest or most interesting, for whatever reason, ways of calculating pi that maybe not many people know about or that haven't been widely covered on YouTube before. The majority of the follow-up video will be dedicated to exploring the different pi computing methods that you all come up with, highlighting some of the coolest ones and how they work. Real quick before we end the video, I know that you all love Brainstorm, and that it's a big part of why a lot of you are subscribed to me, and I want to continue making it a core part of this channel. That being said, these videos take a lot of effort to make, and whether I like it or not, they have to be funded somehow. On YouTube, this often comes in the form of third-party sponsorships, but for Brainstorm specifically, I think it would be nice to have the series be unsponsored, but rather funded directly by you, the viewers, since it's for you, the viewers. If you're on board with that idea, and you'd like to see more community-oriented content down the line, I'd like to ask that you consider becoming a member of my Patreon and joining the names you see on screen now. A bunch of the benefits you'll get when you do are designed to give you a more active role in shaping the content that I put out. You can sign up at patreon.com/purplemindcreations or scan the QR code in the upper right. Another way you can help the channel monetarily, by the way, is to buy one of these Brainstorm coffee mugs. They're actually really nice. I didn't even know this until a few days ago, but a bunch of my family members have been using them pretty much every day because they're just genuinely good mugs. So if you're interested in having one of these for yourself, check it out at store.purplemindcreations.com or scan this QR code. There are also a bunch of other fun merch items there as well. I sincerely appreciate any and all support, and it'll enable me to make more videos like this. All that said, if you'd like to participate in the challenges from this video, there's a link in the description to the full instructions. And if you didn't make it here in time to participate in this one, I'll come back and link to the follow-up video here when it's posted. I'm super excited to see what you all come up with. Thanks to everyone for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.